reaction to the earnings, when the rate was finally advanced, the importance attached to such a move promoted excessive speculation in the shares. Finally, the reinvestment of the enormous sums out of earnings failed to protect the shareholders from a complete loss of income in 1932. Allowance must be made, of course, for the unprecedented character of the Depression in 1932.